Welcome back to my channel. Today we want to talk about leaky gut. What is it? What are the symptoms? What do we have leaky gut? And what we can do about it to prevent or heal leaky gut. Leaky gut is the cause of all the chronic Hashimoto's, lupus, rheumatoid arthritis, multiple sclerosis, psoriasis. These are classified like autoimmunity. Basically, they already find out like there is 100 or more of this condition. And what do we get this chronic disease? Because like I talked in my other videos before, all start with inflammation in the gut. When, you know, when, for example, why is the reason that we have inflammation? Inflammation, it can be many causes. It can be environmental, it can be physical, it can be emotional. And for example, our bodies are continually repairing, restoring, but sometimes when we put too much, when our body is dealing with too much stuff like toxins and we are eating foods that are not healthy or we are under a lot of stress, it can become overwhelmed for our bodies to be dealing with all these things, and then this inflammation start, you know, happening every single day until our body say enough is enough. And then we start feeling like a lot of symptoms, like for example, muscle pain, joint pain, migraine, headache. It can be also chronic fatigue, rheumatoid arthritis. It can be many things that may, it's like a, they call that this, all these a lot of things that our body is dealing with, multifactorial, because it's just not one thing at a time. It becomes everything at a time, and our body has hard time dealing with all these things. And we start also because of our brains are connected with our gut. We also start having a lot of like neurological symptoms, like for example, like brain fog. We can have depression, anxiety. We can have mood swings. And like as I said, this becomes so overwhelming for our body that he is like our body get lost. Gut is basically also is called intestinal permeability. It's when we have a mucosal layer that basically protect us from all this bacteria coming, and then basically our microbiome communicate with the immune system, and this one communicate, and then between them they see if, for example, something that is coming in our system is a friend or is an enemy. When it's a friend, you know, they let it pass and through the bloodstream, and then when there is like your immune system and microbiome think that this is an enemy, basically stop them from coming into our bloodstream. But like when, like I said, when we have a leaky gut, that basically leaky gut is there is this protective barrier that separates the intestine from the bloodstream. And basically, this protective barrier is made from tight junctions. So when these tight junctions open up, is when, you know, like for example, things start going through these holes, and basically it can be things like a protein that is undigested. It can be a pathogen, like for example, a virus or a parasite that going through the our bloodstream, and then, you know, our immune system start like, oh no, there is a you know, an enemy. We have to take care. We have to protect the whole body. And it, they started and they push, it's like they push the alarm and start, you know, sending messages to our microbiome. So to attack these enemies is a war in our, you know, our whole immune system. So our system, like I said, it gets overwhelmed, and then it's when people, it's so much thing going on in their body that people start becoming really, really sick with a lot of symptoms, joint pain, chronic fatigue. You get this all nutritional deficiency. You get, basically your immune system become weak because there's so much thing that is lacking. It doesn't have enough nutrients to be able to handle all this. It become weak. You become tired. You get headaches. You get migraines. You get constipation. One of the things that we can do to help our bodies first, start with an elimination diet. You know, get rid of all those inflammatory foods like gluten, dairy, soy. And also, we're going to get rid of these foods that are full of emulsifiers. They have artificial sweeteners, artificial colors, artificial flavoring. All these things, basically, what they do, they disrupt your lining, and all these things we need to get rid of all then. Also, we have to work and in our sleep. There is another video that I have in my channel. Please go and check. It's very important to sleep well, to have restorative sleep, because during a restorative sleep, our body repairs, restore, detoxify. And then also another thing that we can do is make sure that we also do our exercise. We also have to manage stress. It's very, very important. Another thing that also causes the leaky gut is, for example, that use of antibiotics. Did you know that one use of antibiotics can wipe up all your microbiome, and it takes at least 2 years to be able to repopulate again? Also, there is for example, pesticides, herbicides we ingest through our food. And that's why in my other video, I also recommend you that it's really important that you eat organic food, grass-fed meat, because, to prevent antibiotics that are usually also in our meat. And also make sure that you don't eat any food that contains GMOs, because these GMOs, these crops, have that glyphosate is this antibiotic that they use in the brown Roundup. So these pesticides are really hurtful for our microbes that are in our gut. So try to avoid all the things that have GMOs. Also, another thing that disturb our microbiome and also is the root cause for the leaky gut is also the birth control pills that you use every single day. And the other thing that I recommend you to do to heal your leaky gut is, besides avoiding all these things that really disrupt our gut lining, is, for example, I mentioned some of them before, like try to, eat food that are anti-inflammatory. Try to sleep, have a good sleep every night, do some exercise, manage your stress. But also there is some supplements that also can help you. And I'm not gonna give you any recommendation on doses or anything, because I'm not a doctor, I'm not a scientist, I'm not a researcher. I'm just a mom that I'm sharing my experience, with my autoimmunity. I went and did a lot of research and did a lot of webinars, and I learned all these things, and this became like my mission to share with you. But this just is my personal opinion. So I just gonna recommend you, for example, to recommend you some things that are gonna help you to heal your leaky gut. And one of them, it can be, for example, turmeric. You can use it in your food, or you can also make the goat milk. that this has really like good anti-inflammatory spices that are have anti-inflammatory properties. Like for example, it can be turmeric. Turmeric, you can use the goldmeat with turmeric, ginger, cinnamon. You can put a little bit of honey. You can add a spoon of coconut oil. All these things are really good. Really good together, but also it help a lot with the inflammation. You can also use the slippery elm, also combined with the marshmallow root. In my case, I use the slippery elm and it really helped me. It's like a powder that is completely natural. You put it in boiling water and you do this like a gooey paste that you can drink it as like a tea, and then it really helps your lining to heal. You can use ginger in your food, like add like a spice. And also you can use probiotics. I'm gonna give you, I'm not gonna recommend any brand in specific because remember everyone is different. So you can, you have to find out the one that works for you. Some of them are probiotics that are have some kind of strains. Some of them are soil based, and basically is the, you know, the bacteria that is in the soil. They put it in a pill and then you make it as a pill. For me, it works really well, the probiotics. Also, there is this prebiotic, which is so different from probiotic. The prebiotic is the food that feed the good bacteria. For example, I'm going to give you an example. It's the onion, garlic, leeks, dandelion greens. And these are, like I say, feed the good bacteria. The probiotics are strains that help you. There's basically a good bacteria. They help you to repopulate your bacteria. Bone broth, you can use it. You can make your chicken soup, and basically the bone broth is made to the bones from the chicken. It can be the chicken or it can be the beef, and just drink the liquid. I do not. Sometimes I buy it in the store, but I really rather to do it myself. Sometimes I do the chicken soup and put, you know, a lot of vegetables, onions, I put turmeric, I broil it, and the liquid that is left, I drink it as a bone broth. Sometimes I use the can, but for me, I rather to use everything that is homemade because you know what you put in your food. And also, my channel is more based on how to heal with food. I'm really not a believer of supplements, at least some these ones that I recommend you, because they really work for me, like the probiotics and the slippery elm. And the slippery is totally something from the earth. It has nothing like a preservatives or anything. It's just made from a root. And these things I always recommend you to heal with food, because I always believe in my heart that food is medicine. And all these things, if you combine these things together, I'm pretty sure they are gonna help you to feel a relief in your gut. And also, another thing that I'm gonna recommend you for you that worked really well for me, it was when I having this crisis, really, like I have a lot of pain and I was not be able to digest really well. I usually use more cooked food instead of raw food, because the cooked food are more gentle in your digestive system. And also sometimes, you know, you wanna see that with the changes, doing, you know, all these changes, you still gonna find out that you're gonna, as a human, you're gonna make mistakes and you're gonna eat things that you're not supposed to eat. And for example, like me, one time I ate a piece of cake and then it really feels so tired after that. I feel sleepy. I got that brain fog. I was having a hard time to focus. And then I knew it because it was the gluten. And remember, I did another video about the gluten. Gluten is one of the things that you need to get rid of to be able to hit a leaky gut. And then, like I said, when you make a mistake, like we all do, so try to help your gut to heal fast, like a bone broth, eat cooked food. In some cases, what I did is even I did my chicken soup without the chicken, blended, and then you eat it like a soup, because when the food is blended, the digesting system do not need to work really hard trying to digest that food. It just go into your stomach, and then it doesn't really need much digestion as you put like a piece of carrot or a piece of cabbage or a piece of protein. So these things is help the digestion to go smooth, and then eat like a lot of like things that are warm, because are more easy to digest. More actually really help you to feel more comfort, because that's why they call chicken soup a comfort food, because it really help you to feel warm. I think for today is all that I can share with you. I'm gonna continue sharing sharing more videos. Please subscribe to my channel, and I hope you do this a couple of these steps. You try to incorporate it in your daily life. Do one step at a time, little by little. Don't overwhelm your body, because your body, remember, with your immunity, is already overwhelmed. So as much as you can to help your body to lower that inflammation and be more in this state, or regenerate and rebuild and restore. So please subscribe to my channel, and I see you next time. Thank you. Bye-bye.